Another good camp at San Bernardino. I thought it was very productive for us. I thought we got better every day. And I thought our players really accepted the challenge we presented them this year, starting with what we did the first 2 days down in San Diego right up through today. And I thought we made a lot of progress as a team, on the field and off the field. Got a lot closer, got to know each other better, bonded in ways that are important as you go through a season. So the plan from here is we'll go back this afternoon. We're going to give them tomorrow completely off. I think they've earned it. I think they need it, more importantly. I think that we need to regroup. They need to refresh. We need to sharpen up a little bit, and then we'll get back at it Monday. So excited about where we are, but realizing that we have, like I say a lot, we have a long ways to go. We're nowhere near where we need to be. To be a team that can play with consistency through the season, but that's what we're working towards. And I like their work ethic, and I like their attitude, and I like the way they've come together as a team. So I thought it was a good camp. I thought it was a really good camp.
What do you come away with this year than you got last year about your team?
Well, I think I feel better, Chris, about our starting unit. There's less uncertainty about who our starters are and what they're capable of doing. Still. The uncertainty lies in the backups, in depth. And, I think a lot of young guys, a lot of freshmen, are going to figure into our depth. And I think that what we saw in these last 2 weeks is a really good freshman class. Now we just got to get them up to speed so that if we need them to play, they can play. But I think camp was a little bit different for me this year with respect to our starters and not hitting them as much. Not going live as much with our starters, still pushing them, still demanding a lot of them, but then putting our younger guys in situations where there's more live. So I feel good about our starting groups.
I think it's like Vander does did too much today after playing.
Yeah, we're coming out of this camp really healthy, considering. Ellis is fine. He'll be back out there on Monday. Simon will be back out there on Monday. Ed will be back out there on Monday. Kylie will be back out there on Monday. Someone asked about Eldridge Massington. He just has a little infection in his finger. He'll be good. Pawasi will be back. Ben Wysocki will be back. Hopefully Kevin McReynolds will be back. There's a chance Alex Redman will be back. I thought we, like any camp, you're going to have some injuries. You have some guys that miss practice. But the fact that we can go back out on the field on Monday, a little less than 2 weeks from the Nevada game, and be where we're going to be physically, I think is a good thing, considering the hard work we put in up here.
How about position battles? Anything settled on quarterbacks?
No, nothing settled. Don't want things settled yet. Want competition. Want guys feeling the pressure. Want everyone to feel like they still have a chance and that they're still threatened. I think that's the thing that you want right now. You want to see guys compete. And that's how we'll get better. He's played a lot, so I don't know that it's a big deal. I think probably for him, it's a big deal. Just, emotionally, getting in the mix a little bit, having some bodies around him. I think on Monday, you'll see him do quite a bit more. We still have to monitor him, though, for a couple days, But like I've said all along, we expect him to be full speed for Nevada, and it looks like that's the case.
Led Zeppelin.
I'm gonna have to go Led Zeppelin.
There you go.
Play Led Zeppelin for me any day, and I'll be just happy as heck.
That's the right choice.
There you go, yeah. Coach.
Show my age.
You just lost all good media.
Well, I have to tell you this: that I, you'd go with the Who, I'm sure. Yeah. You'd go with Bruce?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Great concert. When I was in high school, Led Zeppelin came to the Kingdom.
Nice.
I had tickets, yeah. And some Nostradamus person predicted that the decibel level on Jimmy Page or on the guitar, something was going to be so hard it was going to crack, so I didn't go like an idiot. So I never got to see it. I know, just one of the regrets of my life.
That's too bad.
Have you ever treated a hotel room as Led Zeppelin's treated a hotel
room? No. That was the Edgewater in Seattle, I think.
It was.
They had their
famous
legendary moments with the Sharks and things like that.
Right. They were good as a group. Keith Moon as an individual, though.
There you go. I play Led Zeppelin, I'll always be happy.
Sweet.
I'll forget.
Cool.
All right. Thanks, everybody.